Hey there, Michael Church with CrawlspaceNinja.com, and I just wanted to take a moment to go over some energy saving tips for everybody out there. This is the time of year, it's summer, it's getting hot. We right now got a big old thunderstorm going on outside, and this is the time of year people really start to focus on making the house cooler, especially if you have a upstairs that's got a hot bonus room or you got some hot areas in the house. I wish we could work on attics in the winter and crawl spaces in the summer. It'd be a lot better for us, but for some reason it never works out that way. So anyway, I want to go over a couple things. As you can see, I'm on the Energy Star website. I wanted to go over a couple things with you. I want to talk to you about duct sealing today. So this is a great do-it-yourself project that you can try. About 20 to 30% of the air that moves through the duct system is lost due to duct leaks. I don't know if you can see that right there. That is huge. I mean, my goodness, imagine that for every dollar you spend on cooling your home this summer, that you could be losing 20 to 30% or 20 to 30 cents of that dollar in the attic or in the crawl space. So this is a great topic to cover for saving energy. So a few things we want to note here. That how do you know you have poor performing ducts? Well, number one, you know, you have high utility bills. You could have rooms that are difficult to heat and cool. We just finished up a house not too long ago, a couple days ago, that they had their thermostat set on 72 degrees. And in the summertime, it couldn't even get there. It was 80 degrees. That's the lowest they could get. We had to do a few issues. We had to handle, we didn't do any duct sealing. We did some other things. But that's a good start, is sealing the ducts, which is what I'm going to talk to you about today. I'll give you some other tips on those other things. The other thing you want to do is, if you have a stuffy room that never feels comfortable, your ducts are located in the attic, crawl space, or in the garage. Those are most likely places inside the house where you're going to have issues, is in the attic, crawl space, or the garage. Especially garages, they are so hard to control the temperature. Every time you open and close those big old doors, it's got hot air rushing in the summer and cold air in the winter. And then the other thing you want to look at is if you've got flexible ducts that are bent really bad. In other words, you can see them almost at a 90 degree angle. Ducts should almost be straight or as straight as possible. So I've seen ducts wrapped around poles and brought back. Air is hard to move through ducts that are bent. So you want to make sure you check those sort of things. So the benefits of duct sealing, let's get into this. Let's move along to our next slide here. Number one is comfort. A lot of people think, oh, I'm going to save energy. Well, believe it or not, most people choose to do work on their house because of comfort. You know, if you got a hot bonus room, that's going to probably trump the need for saving money because you're trying to be comfortable. So you want to make sure that you seal the ducts. That's the number one reason why people do it. Number two is indoor air quality. Again, save money. No, air quality is a huge, huge problem. If you've got ducts going through your attic or your crawl space that are leaking 20 to 30% of the air, you're going to be pulling insulation fibers, you're going to be pulling mold, you're going to be pulling fumes, different things like that, especially if you have maybe you decide to use those areas as storage facilities. Like, we've been in crawl spaces where people will keep their lawnmower and gas and different things like that, and they're pulling all those chemicals into those leaky ducts, which is eventually circulating into the house. Number three is safety. During normal operation, you got gas appliances and different things venting out, and the better you can seal those ducts, the better the ductwork are sealed, the less likely you're going to have drafts and different things pulling those fumes from carbon monoxide and different things like that and creating a backdraft. The fourth thing is save money. There you go. There's energy efficiency. So, you know, believe it or not, there's three other reasons to do it other than to save money. Now, the byproduct of doing it is going to be to save money. If I can get that, you know, let's say I can get 20 more percent or 15 more percent of the air other than losing 30%, I'm only losing 15%. That's huge, huge savings. So, you know, not everybody's ducts are the same, but if you've got a house built in the 60s or 70s or 80s, You know, chances are your ducts probably are in disarray. They were using a lot more materials back then, so you may want to just get a professional to take a look at it, or if you can get up in the attic yourself or in the crawl space, check the duct out. And the fourth, of course, or the fifth reason why people or why the Energy Star guys think you should seal the ducts is to protect the environment. Obviously, again, that is a great reason to do it, but the less money we can spend, I think these are very important reasons. So the less money you can spend as a consumer, the more money you have in your pocket. So let's check out some information again. Here is the common duct problems and solutions. First, we're going to focus on the problems. Leaky, torn, and disconnected ducts. How do you know if you have those or not? Well, you're going to have to get into the attic or the crawl space or the garage and check those things out. If your heating and air unit is in the garage, go out there on a hot day when you got the AC running, put your hand over those ducts and see if you feel a lot of cold air blowing out. See if you see a lot of condensation on that heating and air unit. Those are things you need to address. Condensation, of course, can lead to mold. Poorly sealed registers and grills. Oh my, oh my. That is hugely overlooked. You know, when we do crawl space work, we seal around those boots. The registers that are coming out of the floor or coming through the attic, the ceiling. You got to seal those or it'll create a backdraft and it'll blow air back up into those spaces. You also want to check the return air grill. Make sure those are sealed real good. Leaks at furnace and filter slots. This is another huge one. All right. If you're using a filter that you got to smash into place, or if you're using a filter where there's a gap around it, in other words, it slides right in and you can shake the filter, that is going to create indoor air quality problems because you're not filtering out all the air. The AirSafe 2000 filter is a great alternative to that. If you get a chance to go to that website, airsafe2000.com, that is a great filter that actually seals around the filter and does not allow air to bypass or go around the filter, so it filters better air. Kinks and flexible ductwork, restriction of airflow. These are common among the flex duct. It's a little bit harder to kink the solid pipe. So you want to make sure, just check those things. Make sure you don't have it turning real hard in a 90 degree angle. Try to keep those angles as easy as possible. It's kind of like when you take a hose, water hose, and you kink it. The water doesn't travel out of the end of the hose as fast. That's the same way with the ducts. Okay, so let's look at the solutions, properly sealing the ducts. By the way, I've got a video I'm going to reference later that shows you exactly how to seal ducts. This is more about why you should seal them. Registers and grills tightly sealed. Seal the furnace and the filter slots. Well-insulated ducts. You got to check your local codes, but around here in Knoxville, East Tennessee, we during new construction would put an R8 insulation on our duct system. They used to use an R6 or an R4, so we've now gotten up to R8, and who knows where we're going to be at in the future. And again, straighten those flexible ducts. If you can figure out a way to get those ducts straighter or to not bend as hard, it's better to have kind of like a cul-de-sac effect in the duct, just a light bend in the duct is better than like this right here. This is more of a light bend, okay? I know that's a 90 degree, but that's better than a bend that comes back around, okay? So, but this is truly the most efficient run of these two runs right here. This run versus this run. This one is going to be pushing more air than this run is, okay? So you wanna have straighter runs if you can do that. All right, so let's move on to the next slide. I want you to watch this video. This is a great example that the Energy Star guys did. And I say guys, I apologize. Could be gals, could be ladies also. So Energy Star personnel put this video together. And I just want to run this for you real quick so you can see exactly what's going on in these leaky ducts. And again, don't just notice the output, but notice here it's pulling in. So you got to make sure these are connected. The return is connected just as well as the output. So that's a great example of how air moves. So you want to get more air into the return and out the supply. Okay, so that's the goal. All right, couple things, and then I'll let you go. This is our channel. We got a couple of, first of all, if you get a chance to subscribe, and we can make sure you get videos as we release them. We've released a bunch of new videos here the past couple of weeks, but take a look at this one first. This is the how to air seal your return air duct. All right, that's a good video. It's got about 15,000 views, but this is our number one video right here, the air duct sealing DIY, how to air seal HVAC ducts, 67,000 views. It was so popular that even the manufacturer of the mastic sealer that we're using contacted us, and we now have that available on our website. So if you need any mastic sealer or any of the supplies that we've got listed in these videos, we can sure get those to you. Again, check these out if you want to see the how-to portion of what I'm talking about. And I hope this video was helpful. If you get a chance, please subscribe for me up here and like the video down below. We'd sure appreciate it. Check out our Crawl Space Ninja website if you get a chance. Just click right there. Takes you straight to our website, the DIY page of our website. There you go. You can get all of our stuff right here. There's the sealers and all that sort of thing in order to seal the ductwork. Hope you guys have a great day, and God bless. Thanks again for watching.